So last week I did one of the craziest thing and read all the Unity's release notes from Unity 2017 to Unity 2020. And I received a lot of positive responses like, why would you waste your time rather than developing your own games, to this is one of the dumbest thing ever made on internet, and all other positive reviews. So let's put aside those reviews, and in this video I'm going to share with you 7 top insights I learned after reading all those release notes for over 4-hour long video. So if you want to watch that video, then click this link and let's begin this video. So the first one is Game Object Recorder. With Game Object Recorder, we can basically record all the gameplay of user or any position of. With Game Object Recorder, you can basically record anything on the Unity game scene and play it back in the future time. With this, you can undo a user move and time travel user without having to custom code everything. So let's see how to implement that. I have set up this sample scene. It has a plane and a ball. When we hit the play, the ball will fall onto the ground. With our Game Object Recorder, we will loop this position. We will calculate this position automatically and we'll loop for falling off ball from top to bottom. So let's see how to do that. Onto the ball, let's enable our ball recorder script. Then we will enable to record. Then in the Unity asset scene, create one animation clip. Geo recorder, set it to loop time, and then go to ball and drag and drop this missing script onto the ball recorder variable. Then open this animator controller. In the ball recorder, drag and drop this. Now let's play the game. First we will record the gameplay by hitting this, enabling this to record. So now our screen, our gameplay is recorded onto this screen. What next we will is, we will disable this to record, so it, our Unity will loop that animation clip from script. I will share with you this code shortly. Yeah, so now if you see, it is looping continuously with our Game Object Recorder. So let's see what this ball recorder does. If you open this, then in the bool2, we are enabling the disabling my animator. Then we are creating Game Object Recorder and passing it type on what Unity should record. So here you can pass your custom script data, your custom variables, basically custom class scripts, or the Unity's default transform game object or anything other like rigid bodies. Then in the late update, we are taking the snapshot of that recorder in time.deltaTime. So time.delta, so we are taking snapshot of every delta time and storing it in the Game Object Recorder. And on disable, we are saving that recorder to the clip, animation clip. And when we disable to record, what it does is enabling the animator and setting rigid ball to kinematic, so Unity's physics doesn't interfere, and it start looping around in that recorded clip. So that's it about Game Object Recorder. Do try it in. The second one is multi-source animation. So Unity recently introduced multi-source animation. With that, what you can do is, in the scene, you can take any object and assign it aim constraint. So say you have a sword and you want it to place around user's hand while animating. You can add the aim constraint on that sword and then assign a source as a hand object. So you don't have to make a child that sword. You don't have to make a child of that particular model. You can put it in the parent and assign a aim constraint to that, and Unity will automatically take care of that thing. So that's about multi-source animations. If you are into 3D games and developing AAA games, then this will be quite handy for you. The second one is rotational, then positional. It's basically like follow that position and etc. you can do. The third one is screen.safe area. if you are into mobile development, then you will notice that there are a lot of curved screens onto the Android and iOS phones, and sometimes our top part of the portion of the UI gets clipped. So you need to introduce this screen not safe area. Using this function, you can basically take how much curve area is on top and how much offset we should add to our UI source. Let's see how to do it in Unity. So I will open this safe area scene. So it just has a canvas and safe area, empty game object. And on this safe area, so always add a safe area empty game object with its anchor position at all the four points. And all the UI always add inside, make a child of this safe area. So instead of this under this canvas, you will add all the areas under this safe area. And on the safe area, we will have a one script safe area. What it does is on enable, it will check for the screen dot height, that is device actual screen height, and it will minus the safe area height, and we will get the offset which we should add to that game object. So whatever offset is there, we will add it here on this safe area, and this area, all the childs under it will get repositioned and with padding. So yeah, this is about safe dot screen area, screen dot safe area, and yeah, that's it for the third one. Then fourth one is Android. So Unity recently added aspect ratio mode. You can go to Android player setting, and under resolutions and presentation, you can set the aspect ratio. So if I go to project setting, then if you are under Android, then you will see resolution and presentation has this native aspect ratio by default. You can make it custom and set up to size of whatever screen aspect ratio you want. I prefer native aspect ratio only, but if you are into some custom coding, then you can use this object option. So the fifth one is preset. With preset, what you can do is, in this ball scene, say we have the rigid body of 100 and we want to add a mass of 100 to all the new balls or new rigid bodies that we will create on the scene, then what you can do is, say for currently if you add rigid body, then setting its mass to 1. But if you want to by default set to 100, then you can click on this preset, second option, then save current to mass 100. Now the preset is created, and you can click this add to rigid body default. Now say if I remove this one and add again the rigid body, it will set this mass to 100. So basically presets are like prefab for components. You can do it for all other transforms, then custom scripts and all those things. So that's the quite handy feature. The sixth one is script only build. If you notice that Unity Remote is getting depreciated, plus Unity Remote doesn't support native libraries like AdMob or Facebook if you wanna do that things. So with script only build, what you can do is, in development build, after you build once and run on your device, you can next time you can just select this script only build. With that, Unity will not recompile all the assets in the data and in the scene, and it will only recompile the custom script code. That way it will build faster on your device, and it will increase your testing time, decrease your testing time and fasten up your speed. The last and seventh is game SDK. If you Google it, game SDK, you will find that Unity has recently collaborated with Google and came up with this native framework for Android, which can help boost your performance of any game. So you can download the SDK plugin from this official Android development site, and using that you can increase your game's performance. So yeah, those are the 7 points. The first one is game object recorder. Second one is multi-source animation. Third one is screen.safe area. Fourth one about aspect ratio mode. Fifth one about presets, then script only build, and the final one is game SDK. So those are the 7 points I learned after reading all the Unity release notes. And if you like this video, then hit like. If you dislike, then hit dislike. And make sure you subscribe to my channel. So you can weekly get updates on Unity 3D game development and a lot of the other things. See ya.